Ready for the next battle.
Okay. As I look around, we the only niggas with that A1 Perico. I'm smoking dope, I'm on my cell phone. I'm selling dope, straight off the iPhone. He want a quote, he talking 9 zone. He bought 4, I front him 5 more. 9 piece, straight 8 balls. MJG, bitch, I got 8 balls. 9 piece, straight 8 balls. MJG, bitch, I got 8 balls. Swap out, still independent. Distribution Mexican, he still sending. No contract.
Take my word.
Okay. All
right.
Yeah.
All right.
That's it right there.
All right. Cool.
Right, I thought Max Crosby jumped on the screen for a minute, the way he started smiling and shit, man.
Right. Now, Bundy, Van, just want to let y'all know. And my brother, Don Juan. Hey, man, this one's for you, brother.
Get ready for the next battle.
Good times. That's my shit. I ain't gonna hold you. That's my shit right there.
Hey, Donnie, on the count of 3. 1, 2, 3. Same color thunder, nigga.
Let me go first real quick.
That's my shit.
Go ahead, bro.
Now, like, Ross, he kind of... Well, this is kind of his second stage of his career. He had to extend.
Yeah, this is second one. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So he was one of the people that made that transition. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. He made the transition over. So salute to Ross on that.
This is back against the wall, Ross, too.
Yeah. Listen, that's when niggas find out things.
Yeah.
This is when niggas see. First see Tia Kemp when she had that fur on.
Right. Yeah, she had that fur.
Yeah. He was hanging out with the money team.
Or now she looked like Nora.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm crying.
But OJ the Juice Man.
That was a strong year for Juice Man, dog.
That was a strong year for Juice. Real good strong year.
Nah, I'ma show love to Juice. Hey.
Throughout history, OJ the Juice Man is pivotal in hip hop history. You want to know why? Because OJ the Juice Man is when the South said, "Nigga, enough is enough. We not playing that shit. y'all niggas ain't gonna be disrespecting us no more, nigga." And then from that moment on, it's been extreme South. So, and you want to know why? Because people fuck with OJ so heavy. People love OJ the Juice Man. So
even the real East Coast niggas tapped into OJ. Shout out to Jada.
Exactly. Jada.
Who's real? Who's not?
You know what? I'm gonna throw another one on there. Red Cafe.
Yep. Red Cafe. He tapped into. Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Shabby, yep.
But I'm gonna go with Ross. But I'm gonna ask you guys this question, round table, quick question. what was going on in your life when I'm Getting Money came out?
Oh, nigga, I was getting money, nigga. I was getting money. I'm getting money did two things.
If you wasn't getting no money, it gave you the bubble guts and you sat in the corner. But if you was getting money, you was flashing that money and counting that money. I was flashing that money. No bubble guts over here.
Listen, man, nigga, that shit, cop a chicken. You know what I'm saying?
When I'm getting money first came out, I was doing the spread challenge before Kodak. So,
By the way, it's about 10 minutes left, so y'all got some time. I was in that Caprice around that time too, nigga. I was on all bullshit.
Mm-hmm. I first met Youngin when I'm getting money came out. That's when I met Youngin, so that's what the rhythm connected.
Nah, what's that picture of Larry with all the money, bro? That's the official I'm getting money. That's futuristic Larry.
That's DJ the Juice Man. Yep. Hey, man, what's the shit called? A Canon event?
Yeah, that's a Canon event. Yeah. Everybody like
that was his Canon event.
I'm getting money's a Canon event.
That's the original Show Your Work.
Yeah, for real. That's the origin story. I know niggas saying last class.
I gotta go with Juice Man on this one, bro.
I think he does gotta get some votes. Right. He does.
So, but here's the thing.
I respect it because that was strong year.
All
right. I understand it, right? But I just want to put in perspective what Ross did in that year.
Nigga.
It's not just BMF. Not just that.
Mm-hmm.
He's the first. He's the immovable object that hit the unstoppable force.
Yeah,
and it moved. Nobody put a chink in 50's armor before, and he did it again and again and again, and again and again and again.
And 50 was doing his best shit to bring out Ross.
He was trying, dog. Curtis had already not really
pimping Curly.
Yeah, like he tried. He went and got Khaled's mom and shit. He tried. And then Ross dropped BMF and nobody gave a fuck no more.
So, here's my thing with that.
Hold on, Bunny. I got him. No. Let him finish. I got you.
So I understand what Juice Man did in that year. Trust me. No disrespect to Juice Man, but Ross kicked off and started one of the most legendary runs in hip hop. Like, that nigga didn't give us a bad project from Deeper Than Rap all the way until Hood Billionaire. I'm gonna say not one. And that shit kicked off then. So, I mean, features, all the shit. I mean, shit, he's the best rapper of all time out of Florida. He's one of the 10 best rappers out of the South. He's one of the 50 best rappers of all time, no matter the coast. I mean, shit, man. It's fucking Ross.
So, Bundy, I cut you off respectfully before Van votes to bring up, you know, an important fact here. So, the thing about OJ that makes OJ so great that nobody wants to acknowledge is that before OJ the Juice Man, and you can admit this as a Gucci Man fan. I hope Van keeps it honest about this too.
Mm-hmm.
We like Gucci. We fuck with Gucci. But to me, OJ the Juice Man not only stepped out in an area where, again, like Winston said, it's snap and pop shit going on. It's a lot of weird mohawk hairstyles and shit. But OJ came out on some real Project Pat shit. And number two, OJ Juice Man, and y'all can quote me on this, is the reason that you niggas respect Zaytoven beats. Because if it wasn't for OJ the Juice Man, none of them Zaytoven beats and church melodies that y'all like so much wouldn't happen. Also, since we want to talk about people fighting against the odds and not, you know, all that, because y'all bring up this 50 Cent beef, and that was cool. I respect that. Let's talk about what you do when the most viral person in the world, a teenager from Mississippi, says that I'm going to go to Atlanta and I'm going to copy your style word for word, bar for bar, make songs with your shit, and you still put out enough strong shit. You tell the motherfucker publicly, hey, get the fuck on.
That job, man.
And you had to change. Buddy had to change his whole fucking style. Buddy had to change
his whole fucking style. It's in the plan. Yes, sir.
So, here we go. You got, you talking about BMF, right? And how that gets played in the club from back then, right? We got Vet Pass By. We got I'm Getting Money.
Come on now.
Pop a Chicken. We got Make the Trap Say A, which got three or four music videos, by the way. You know what I'm saying?
Kids learn fractions from that song.
Come on, man. Listen, OJ was so hard. He basically is the Bricks remix. This Gucci's not even on the Bricks remix except for the hook. It's OJ who got Fabulous, A-Ball, and MJG, and Shawty Low, rest in peace, on that song. So if you asking me about impact, granted, Ross, you cannot deny what Ross did that time period. But if we're going impact, I would say Ross's impact to me is bigger when the MMG albums come out the following year. So that's me. So my vote is OJ the Juice Man. But and Bundy, go ahead, because I know we got to let Van go before this timer
runs. I'm going to just say this. I already picked OJ. Ross had to take another nigga's sound to really hit that whole another thing. So I'm going to just leave it at that. I go OJ.
OJ didn't have to do that. You feel me? Because if Waka Flocka Flame did not exist, we wouldn't have the shit Rick Ross had, because he had to go get Lex Luger because he fucked with what Rock, what Waka and OJ and then was doing in Atlanta. But, you know, Van, the floor is yours, brother.
Oh, nah. Shout out to OJ, man. I respect OJ. I respect OJ, man. OJ, he came out real, bro. Early, he stuck to what he talked about. He ain't trying to do no R&B songs with niggas. He gonna hit you with that hard trash shit. Not fuck with OJ, man. Nigga, going to school every day, bumping that OJ with that motivation. You know what I mean? I love, but like that raw shit is deeper than rap, mafia music, nigga. Like Maybach music too. Like it's just undeniable shit. Like, and I didn't realize that he did that shit in the same like year. I didn't know all that shit came out in a year. Deeper than rap, then Teflon, and all that shit. Our Anastasia. Cause I remember the summer that dropped, nigga. I was on Two Dope Boys.
Well, Deeper Than Rap is 09. Now, Albert Anastasia.
Yeah. Deeper Than Rap was 09.
Yeah, Deeper Than Rap is 09. Albert Anastasia is May 2010. And then Teflon Don is
August or September?
July. And Ashes to Ashes is December. So
yeah,
right. I was in high school and I was printing the CDs. That's how I remember y'all. So.
Yeah, that's how my brain works too with the timelines. Yeah. Like I was printing the CDs.
But you know, like I said, man, I knew Ross was gonna win because like it's Ross. But hey, man, OJ ain't no punk bitch, man.
Yeah, I love OJ, bro. True,
man. OJ ain't no.
Yeah, punk bitch. Nah, it's no disrespect to OJ at all.
No. It's Ross, but you know.
I'm definitely bumping. I'm getting money all day tomorrow. I'm letting you niggas know now. That's right. Shout out to Ross. Right. Shout out to OJ. Well,
shout out to my guy, Rick Ross, man.
Nigga, Vet Pass By, boy.
Hey, man.
Yeah, that's music.
Come on, bro. Come on.
We got Van got Ross. And, Bundy, you pick OJ. Larry, you pick OJ. So we got to get Earl and Winston. We got 2 minutes left in regards to.
Oh, Earl and Winston already picked. Earl.
No, we already picked. Yes.
Oh, we got picked Ross because that's a good friend.
Yeah, Ross won that one.
Ross wins in a 3-2.
Ross won like by that much. So,
yeah. So Ross wins by the hair of his chinny chin chin.
Yeah, because it ain't on his head. So, yeah.
That's crazy.
That's a shot, but that's pretty funny.
Back then?
It's pretty funny.
Hey, he tapped in with me. All right, I'm gonna feed into the joke. He tapped in with me. I can say that shit. So
There you go. About time. There we go. Nah. Yes, sir. Larry Prince Jr.
Yard
yes,
man. Blizzard. That's crazy. Hey, man. All right.
Larry Prince.
Let's get to the comments before we get to the last matchup of the first round. So we got Ashton says, can this be a push? What the fuck?
I don't know what a push is.
I don't know what the hell that mean, but all right.
Yeah.
AJ Rose by a landslide. Same color thunder. Same color thunder.
Shout out to Young Juice, man.
Hey, definitely go
with it. I appreciate you asking that question about where we were because OJ the Juice being a national phenomenon needed to be talked about because it wasn't just the South. So
yeah, absolutely.
You know what though? Do we got any more minutes left in deliberation, real quick? Man, not that we ain't choose, but
the votes are done. But if you want to talk about something,
I think OJ kind of, as much as people was making fun of Styles back in the day, bro, like coast to coast, you couldn't deny that motherfucker could make a hit, man. Like that motherfucker, dog, like. I don't want to hear none of that old niggas from this coast can't rap niggas from this. Like, that nigga OJ had hits, and we don't give a fuck about none of that shit. So,
bruh, the main.
Especially
said,
with them beats, too.
Yeah, he them said, beats, like, that shit was over.
He
especially
said,
our generation.
Same color. Thunder don't even have a damn
color.
With it, dog.
But, you just gotta live
it,
with it.
And you seen it, though. You said it and you seen it.
You seen it. You seen it.
Yo, Tia came before the crack pipe is crazy, Donnie.
And bro, like, him and Gucci, I don't give a fuck what they said on the track. You ever read the lyrics, what they said? Sometimes some bullshit. But Shop I alone. Believe them niggas. Hey, I believe every fucking thing
Gucci.
They said.
Hey, bro, the original.
This is a crazy pocket.
The original So Icy Boys is.
Oh, nigga, undefeated.
Undefeated. Yeah. That's the 2000. That's the 2002 Lakers, dog. Like, you're not fucking with them, bro.
Yeah,
so,
dog. Yeah.
That's the 04. That's the 03, 04 Pistons, dog. Like, they can't be fucked with, bro. So, yeah. But, alas. Alas, we got to go to this final round, and I'm going to kick it over to my player partner.
Nah, y'all young as hell. Actually, I was in third grade.
Yeah, man.
Hey, shout out to the youth for tapping in, man.
Shout out to the youth for being tapped in, though.
Yeah. Fuck with your uncles talking shit right now. Which, let me shamelessly say, shout out to Marcel and tap in what Marcel has coming up very, very soon. I ain't gonna say when, but
no, Marcel made the chap say it was a moment.
Yes, sure. Yes. Mm-hmm. Marcel got some cold shit on the way, so shout out to him.
Chop a cat and chair, walk and nail something like a palm.
Oh, and I see my dog AJ in the comments, man. Hey, man. Because I don't know how my weekend gonna be, bro. So I'm gonna say it now, man. Happy early birthday, bro. Salute to you, man.
For sure. Yes, 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 yes.
Yes, sir. Happy birthday, bro.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Come on, Chloe. Urge, bro. We say urge because of Juice, man. Come on, man.
Urge. All right, man. So we got for the winners again. A recap is Waka, Ross, and T-Pain. My bad. I almost fucked that up.
Florida in this bitch heavy.
So Waka, Ross, and T-Pain. So let's wrap up the first round, and we're about to play that matchup right about.